tattooing has always intrigued me in the largest way, just because I just felt deep down that there was something more about it than, you know, just drawing on paper or just painting on a canvas or something. I definitely knew that in high school, tattooing definitely was going to be something that I could see myself doing for the rest of my life. I wanted to be a tattoo artist when I was 9 years old. Was the age that it actually kind of sparked for me. I grew up being around art quite a bit. That's kind of crazy. Most people would think, hey, I want to be a firefighter, I want to be a police officer, you know, I want to be, you know, a nurse or something, or a doctor. But tattooing has always intrigued me in the largest way, just because I just felt deep down that there was something more about it than, you know, just drawing on paper or just painting on a canvas or something. I definitely knew that in high school, as I was progressing my artist, the artist within me, tattooing definitely was going to be something that I could see myself doing for the rest of my life. So I had been a teacher assistant for, you know, 2 years, my junior and senior year. Realism was, I guess, a groundbreaker for me. I had been doing portraits. I was actually painting portraits, acrylic and oil. Following all these surrealist artists, I definitely started seeing myself transform into, yeah, surrealist artist, really. I mean, I could see myself doing that, you know, for, you know, the better part of my career, you know, whether or not it was just for 5-10 years and I branch off and do something else, or if it's my entire career. But out of high school is when life hit me, you know. Things got real. It was super fun, you know. You know, just being able to go home and just draw and paint and do whatever, play guitar or whatever. But life hit me, and I knew that I had to make a big step. And I was 17 years old when I had graduated, and I knew that I needed to make a move. I had met up with some of my family members, with my parents, and I went to this biker rally down in Boston. It was actually called Border Riders. And I was there just drawing on, you know, my brother, my mom, you know, my stepdad at the time. And there was a tattoo studio down there, and I had gotten, you know, affiliated with them. They seen that I was drawing on my family members, and they asked me if I wanted to draw stencils for them. I was like, well, what's that? You know, I had no idea, you know. So I was drawing stencils for them for the weekend. And yeah, it was definitely something that I saw myself doing, you know. I was just there for a weekend, you know, party with my mom and stepdad. And I mean, it's the last thing I expected, you know. So it almost seemed like a calling, you know. And I believe 100% everything happens for a reason. And I just ran with it. So I got back to Medford, and I was, you know, I was dead set on doing something. I was like, I need to do something, Mom. I need to get going, you know. So, you know, I took this opportunity and I ran with it. And the day came, and I told my mom, I'm like, Mom, I'm ready to start my career, you know. And she said, all right, son, I'll take you, you know. So she brought me down to Elkhorn, down by Lake Geneva here in Wisconsin, and I started my career. I had no money, literally nothing to my name. I had some clothes on my back, that was it. I didn't even bring everything with me, you know. I knew that this was as real as it could get. It was a time for me to step up or go home, you know. And I got to the studio, the interview, if you will, and I was nervous, dude. I was a nervous wreck, you know. I just turned 18, you know, and I was just like, what do I do, you know? And I was just hoping to God that this guy wasn't gonna like just kick me out the door, you know. And I got there, and he said, all right, I'm gonna be giving you a little test here to see where you're at. And he's like, you're gonna do a pinup on my apprentice's side. I'm like, what? You know, I'm like, what the hell is a pinup, you know? And he's like, he showed me the design concept, and I'm like, oh my God, I don't even know if I can do this, you know. And I mean, I didn't do a terrible job, you know. It wasn't the greatest thing, but it was definitely wasn't magazine worthy, let's just say that. But he said it, you know. He's like, he handled it good, man. And he's like, I'm proud of you taking the commitment on that. And they were gonna let you get your feet wet, you know. And I was like, what? And he's He's like, you're hired. I'm like, no way, dude. You know, like, I just buried my hands in my face. You know, I just, after everything that, you know, I was always told, you know, that I was never gonna, you know, amount to anything, and I was gonna just work those 9-to-5 jobs, you know, just factory life for the rest of my life. Not saying it's a bad thing, but it's just, you know, I just knew. I was like, there was a reason why I had to come here. There was a reason why I, you know, went to that biker rally. There was a reason why I met so-and-so. You know, there was a reason for everything. So, you know, I was so grateful for the opportunity that it gave me, that I did everything and anything that I could to make sure that I wasn't going to let him down. My mom eventually actually moved down by me, which was kind of nice. But so I always had that relationship with her, you know, as all my other siblings were venturing off and doing their own careers, you know, having kids, whatever it was. You know, we all stayed in very close contact, still having family get-togethers, picnics, brother-sister days. So that was definitely, you know, something I never wanted to, like, you know, unchain, if you will. I wanted to keep that bond strong, you know. So growing up wasn't easy at all. You know, as much as I don't, you know the whole size of stories and all the different things that laid out and, you know, why we're, you know, in this new house, or why are we moving to that new house, or why did me and my siblings get separated. I remember a few different times we got separated, and it was one of the hardest feelings I've ever had to go through, you know, especially, you know, going to school, all those days, you know, that we were separated, and being able to see them, and then going home with, you know, a neighbor or a friend or something. And it was hard to not be able to, you know, sleep in the same house as them growing up. But I definitely, I don't take anything for granted, you know. I don't take anything that comes in my life as a grain of salt. I'm very appreciative of everything that has ever, you know, stepped in front of me, you know, whether it was somebody's advice or somebody giving me a helping hand. You know, I don't ever just wash it away. It was just, it was hard times that we went through. There was, you know, a lot of times I didn't know if I could help my mom. You know, I thought about getting a job, you know, when I was younger, just shearing trees just to help pay bills if it was hard on her. But I never understood any of that stuff, you know, because I was, again, just trying to be a kid. And, you know, from the days that I'd come home, you know, I was a teenager and she was on the couch sleeping, and, you know, it's instilled in my brain. It's almost traumatizing, because, like, it's, a lot of people would just, like, look at that as a, oh, well, you know, she's coming home, she's tired, whatever, but it was, you know, she was struggling, you know, she was definitely working grueling hours just to make ends meet, you know, and we were already poor as it is, you know, getting hand-me-downs or garage sale clothes or whatever it was. You know, we didn't have Christmases many years, you know, because we couldn't afford it. There was a deeper story behind it, you know, as to reason why, you know, a sadder side, I guess, but I believe that, you know, all of that made us stronger, you know, and just appreciate each other more and appreciate the things that we do get in life more. And you just gotta take it for what it is, you know. You either adapt and overcome, or you stay down. And we chose to adapt. I don't know, my family means, we actually all have like a pretty sentimental tattoo that we all got together. It's a representation of who we all are. But the entirety of our tattoos all spell out the word family. There's six of us, so it just kind of worked out perfectly. We all got a letter in the word family that kind of represented us. You know, started from oldest to youngest. I was an L, so I thought I was like loser. But I have an upside down tattoo on my thigh that I actually had all of them do. So I was tattooing at that studio down in Elkhorn for a good seven and a half months. I had gotten in trouble and wasn't expecting it, you know, gotten in trouble with the law, and I was set to serve a 3-month Huber term, and I was afraid to turn myself in. So I had gotten afraid, and I went back up. I was going on my way to to serve my time, but I stopped in Wausau actually on my way, and I wanted to see some old buddies of mine that I haven't seen in a while, and I decided to set up shop right in their kitchen. Kitchen magician, here we go. I was just having too much fun, you know. I spent the night there, started hanging out with them more. It's actually how I met Tanya. I was working out of the house, and one of her friends had said, hey, you know, you should come with me to get a tattoo. You know, I'm going to get a tattoo at this guy, he's in the house and whatever. And she's all like, hell no, like, don't wait. And she's like, this doesn't even sound good. So whatever, long story short, she comes to the house, she follows with her, whatever. And I was leaning over working on, I think, a thigh or something, or a back or something. But they walked in the door, and she sat on the couch, and I didn't even see her at all. And I was working, and then I ended up just like looking up, and she looked up like a dead exact time, and we locked eyes, and that was it. And I mean, the rest is history, really. I mean, we had a summer of love, you know. And I told her a little bit about, you know, what was going on with my situation, and you know, she understood at the same time, wanted me to make the right decision, was really putting a lot of things in perspective for me, and you know, what I'm hurting, you know, by doing that. And you know, it caught up with me. You know, I got picked up in a parking lot, guns drawn. You know, it's one of the scariest moments of my life, you know. And I got revocated on my time, and I sat 3.5 years for it. I mean, I made amends, you know, with my past. I'm a better person because of it. You know, everybody does wrong, you know. I was wrong and got caught, you know. So Tanya was with me for quite a while I was sitting. So I was drawing a lot of portraits of her, actually, you know, because I just wanted to keep that connection and that bond strong with us. And eventually, as time was progressing and she was hoping that I was going to get out, it was inevitable. She was going to leave, you know, so she did. And I had to let her go. Just had to suck it up. But I drew as much as I could, take my time, you know, take my mind off of things, and just, you know, stop freaking out. And you know, that I can't be held in here forever is my whole thought process. But I knew that when I got out, you know, I wanted to make something of myself in the career, you know, in tattooing. So I was drawing tattoo related things that was going to be based off of my shop. And I've got images that I drew back in 2010. Well before I got out, and well before my studio actually opened up, that was revolved around New Life Inc., Forgive and Forget. That was a big tag. I signed every one of my images with it, with an FF logo on the bottom, and everything. So I was drawing images that were inspiring to me in a way of just overcoming, you know, a lot of overcoming images. And I knew that when I got out that I needed to make a better change with my life, more positive direction. And I felt like I was ready, you know. So and in 2010, I got out, and I was it just felt like one thing after another, you know. I was set for a MR, mandatory release, and there was something of restitution that I had to pay still on my court documents that I needed to pay before I got let off on everything. I'm like, this is crap, you know. So I was set on extended supervision for the time that I got out until I paid it off, and it was a few short months after. But they put me in a halfway house for 7 days right off the bat, because they needed to approve of where I was going to live, that I wasn't going to run again or deviate from what I needed to do. I you know, I got the approval, I was living with my sister in Chippewa Falls, and I started working out of the house there again. And from there, I was developing, you know, how do I get it, you know, how do I open up a studio, you know? But, you know, fate brought me to where I was at, you know, where I needed to go. You know, I ended up connecting with Tanya again, you know, just through texts and messaging and stuff. And I didn't actually see her at the time. And then eventually I did see her. I made the commitment and I was, you know, I went to Wausau and I stayed with her for a few days and I was driving back and forth to Marshfield. I was working at a local studio there for a short time and just found out some bad juju about that and I backed out of there. So I was just like, you know, there's a reason, you know, there's something pushing towards, you know, pushing me towards opening up my studio and I need to do it. I was afraid of opening up in Wausau due to the amount of artists that were here. You know, I didn't want to open some, you know, shop up with the very little 7-month experience that I had and fall on my face, you know, because that's generally what a lot of times happens with, you know, artists that don't have a lot of experience. And I felt that Marshfield was the opportunity for me. So I got connected with Century 21. Gave him my business plan and didn't really have a resume, but I just gave him my business plan of what I was gonna plan to do in the time that I was here. If I signed a contract with them for 3 years and they liked it, they said, here's a key, Jeff, you have a week to get us $2,000. And that's where New Life Inc. was born. In June 2011, we signed a contract to open up New Life Inc. It was 108 West 2nd Street in Marshfield, Wisconsin. And I knew from that point things were as real as it could ever get. You know, it was dire try, you know, and I, fight or flight, you know, it was, I needed to do something. So I made every bit of connection that I could, every bit of commitment and no sleep to make ends meet. It was a struggle for the longest time, just even getting, you know, I mean, I got, you know, that week to get that $2,000. I got the health inspection done in that time. Roll a vinyl floor on a carpet, TV tray dinner, used as a, you know, to hold all my supplies on, fold out metal chairs. I mean, I didn't even have a computer system for, you know, for my shop when I first opened up. I had a calendar, big desk calendar, and an old desk from like a school or something. It was terrible, but you know, I needed to start somewhere, you know, and it was a daily struggle, you know, from learning as much as I could about, because I didn't have a business degree, didn't know really too much about a business. I knew how to run a tattoo studio and what I needed to do day in and day out to make sure that the proper health and sanitation was met. Health and safety was, you know, a big priority for me. So I had Tanya by my side, you know, handling all the business stuff, you know, phone calls, messages, Facebook. You know, once we got a Facebook page, we you know, she was managing that. Calendar, scheduling people, running errands, and even at this time, you know, she was holding her own job as well. She just had a newborn too, so that was really hard on her. There was a lot of times that she wasn't, you know, be able to help me. You know, she wasn't there at the shop to really help me maintain it. So the more that I was tattooing day in and day out, you know, word of mouth was the biggest thing in that time. And It just happened, you know. I don't know what day it happened, or you know what time of the year it happened, but people started flocking in the door more, and it was me turning the money back into the business, you know, vice versa, back and forth, you know. And I still didn't have a car. There was multiple days I was getting rides, and I'm sure the people that are watching, you know, will be able to raise their hand and be like, hey, that was me, you know. You know, there was a lot of people that definitely helped me get to where I was at, you know, because a lot of the times when I needed rides, it was rides to get to an appointment, you know, and or it was rides to get to Marshfield if I was staying back in Wausau with Tanya, you know, for the night. And it was definitely one of the biggest struggles I had to go through, but it was necessary for me to make these small steps in order to get to the bigger picture. The community has been a big part of New Life Inc. since the beginning in Marshfield. For the 3 years that I was there, we had done a lot of different charitable events to help bring business and other revenues through the door. You know, teaming up with the neighbor's place, we've done, you know, breast cancer calendars, you know, helping out families in need, families that are struggling. We've built a playground in honor of a child that passed away. There was countless events, you know, that we've done. There's too many to name off, but from one of our first events that we ever had, it reached almost three blocks in length. So we had over 300 people that came to this event, and it was, you know, by far probably one of the biggest events that we've actually had. It was for a great cause. It's for Apples for Kids charity event. In 2014, I moved the studio over to Wausau. We were in a kind of secluded area. It wasn't really, I mean, there was high traffic, but there's not, you know, there was no other businesses really connected to us. So we were, again, we felt kind of alone still, but, you know, with all the relationships that I developed and created in Marshfield, those people followed, you know, and I couldn't be any more grateful for everybody that still believed in me at that time, which, I mean, the work was subpar at best. You know, I'm not tooting my horn or anything, but, you know, I thought I was a shit, you know, kind of back then, but, you know, definitely a little realization happened for me. But once we came over here, you know, I think my work stepped up a little bit. You know, we got into a bigger location, had more artists started working for me, and just had a little bit different business model of what New Life Inc. was. So we were there for 3 years, and then I decided to move it into the location that I'm in now. This one is it's connected to a couple, you know, bigger businesses. We're in a strip mall, but it's in a more centrally located, you know, high traffic. You know, definitely a lot of traffic, you know, driving through here. So I'm pretty happy with where we're at right now. The clientele, again, you know, we have a sign, you know, it's not huge, you know, it's lit up for sure, but, definitely the clientele and the word of mouth has been, you know, still one of the biggest things for us. You know, they followed us here. They've been super supportive. You know, we've had a couple events out of here since we've been here in 2017. And, you know, they continue to show their love and support, you know, each and every day. You know, all the artists are busy day in and day out. We get a lot of people that are, you know, messaging the New Life Inc. page on Facebook, as well as emails, phone calls constantly throughout the day. Just loving the work. So everybody's been, you know, as consistent as they can be here. And it's surreal. It's every single day I wake up, it's a surreal feeling that I get to come into this work environment and enjoy what I do. Me and my crew here, we're here to give you the best experience, you know, that you can get, you know, from the minute that you walk in, the meet and greet to, you know, the obvious procedure. We'll run you through the whole sterilization process and how everything is done here. We have a full outlined aftercare sheet as well as a digital format of one for you to take home with you. And we just want to make sure that you're 100% happy with the design. You know, with digital artwork coming as vast as it has, the way that the tattoo industry has formed has been more around the digital age here. So we do a lot of our work off of our iPads now, and we'll take a photo of your tattoo and we'll show you exactly what it'll look like on the part of the body that you're getting it done before it's actually even done. So again, everything that has come, you know, my way, I'm super appreciative for. Most tattoos that I do now take, you know, anywhere from 10 to 15 hours in a sitting to do. So it's 6 days a week for me. So you can imagine it's quite a bit of hours that I am away from my family. But I wanna thank the mother of my kids, Tanya. You shed light on so many different things that I didn't see at the time, couldn't see, failed to see, didn't want to see, but ultimately made me see. It just inspires me every single day. To want to just do bigger and better things, you know, be the better dad, travel the world, you know, do things that I never thought were possible, you know, and have just a better setup for our children's life, you know, something that we never had, you know, and I envy everything that you do. Like, it's such an inspiration, day in and day out, that I talk to you, you know, whether it's a little message or if you swing down, give me a something for lunch. I mean, you help me see, you know, you're almost like the devil's advocate in a positive way, you know. So what is it, an angel's advocate, you know, what is it? If I'm down and out about something, you know, I'm just like, I don't know about today, or I don't know about this tattoo, or I don't know about this. And you're like, you know, you got this, you know, you have the right mindset about it, you have the drive, the passion, you know, you got this, you know. And sure enough, I have that positive mindset and boom, you know, knocked it out of the park, you know. And I go home and I just gotta shake my head and I'm like, how do you know, you know, how do you know how to be that way? I don't get it. But I'm just appreciative of you, you know. Thanks for being the mother of my kids, you know, and I love you. I want to thank my mom. You've been my rock. You are my rock. Get out of it, Jeff. And I know that I just want to tell her, you know, because it's like I don't get to see her every day, and I don't get to talk to her on the phone every single day, and you just never know when, you know, life's gonna happen, you know. And I dread, you know, the day that I lose her, you know. But I mean, it's inevitable. It's how life is. But I seriously would not have the work ethic that I have, you know, just with everything that I watched her do growing up. I mean, she was a jack of all trades, you know. She could work on cars, she could do carpentry, there was not a thing that this woman couldn't do, you know. And I envy that, because I mean, there's still shit that I question. I'm like, what are you doing? What is that? What are you doing? She's like, I'm putting a screen in. I'm like, oh, right on, you know. I kind of feel like a dummy, you know, but it was stuff, you know, that she just knew how to do. And you know, I grew up in a household, you know, full of girls, you know. But so I mean, a lot of times I was in a kitchen, you know, I wasn't in no garage. So it was just you know, learn what mom's doing, you know. And thankfully, you know, she had, you know, all those different skills about her. It just gave me the proper work ethic, you know. I believe that if she can work those grueling hours and come home and still have time to make supper for all of her kids, and, you know, go to bed early and wake up super early the next day and do it all over again, you know, 6 days a week, I can too, you know. There's no reason why I can't. And I feel that, you know, each day that I spent with her has been one of the biggest blessings that, you know, I could have, you know, that God could have given me. And I understand that, you know, life happens, life takes people in different directions, you know. But everything that you've showed me, the time that you've spent with me, you know, talking to me about business, talking to me about my career path, just giving me that push, that was just enough to, I guess, to rub off on me and give me that proper push in life, you know, that I think every person should have, to chasing their dreams, you know. And every single day, every night, you're just my rock. As time progresses, there's only up from here, you know. There's no going down. Everybody that has been supportive of New Life Inc. since the beginning, I appreciate wholeheartedly every single dollar that you've ever spent, every single minute that you've ever spent talking to me, or talking to one of my artists. Giving every one of my artists an opportunity, whether they were beginning or if they were just an apprentice. I do have two apprentices that are successfully running studios right now in local cities. And I have an apprentice right now who's going to do hopefully the same. You know, I have all the faith in him. the crew that I have by my side, Jordan, Haley, and AJ. I couldn't be any more grateful to have you guys by my side. Like, you guys are the push that I need every single day, the drive that I inspire to be, you know. And I think collectively we work well together. You know, actually AJ is, I gotta single him out for a second here. He's been one individual that I've leaned on probably the most since moving my studio over to this exact location, because he's the number one reason why the studio even is what it is. You know, I needed a lot of help. You know, because as business goes on, I'm just going to cap off for a second here. As business goes on, year by year, day by day, you know, I was learning everything as I went. You know, I didn't have anybody holding my hand to show me how to do a specific tattoo. It was me, you know, going to a convention and learning. And, you know, as far as, you know, running a business, I didn't know what was a proper direction for me, you know, as far as consent forms, you know, how do I lay those out? How do I lay the proper aftercare form out to be, you know, more elite than the next? You know, there was a lot of questions that I had in my head that I needed answered, and I didn't have the hand holding me to show me. So it was just a lot of just trial and error. So, and day by day that I do it today is trial and error. You know, nobody's perfect, but, you know, AJ's been a big, you know, big reason why the studio is what it is. And, the layout, you know, down to, you know, taking the time away from his family. He's got a family of four and a wife, spent grueling hours, you know, trying to make it, you know, work. Make certain things work in the studio. That was, you know, hardships, you know, from the marble epoxy floor to the ceiling trim, you know. He was here from start to finish, and I'm definitely appreciative of that. But I just really want to thank all my customers, the clients and supporters that have been here, you know, since day one, that have continued to show their love and support for my studio and their belief in me. Every single day that I get to wake up, come to my studio, it's a blessing. You know, it's the greatest thing, you know, a greatest feeling that I could have, to know that, you know, hopefully for the rest of my life that I get to do this passionate thing that I've long endured to become. You know, 9 years old, you know, I mean, that's crazy to most people. You know, they'll just look at it and be like, what, 9? But I, every moment, every part of me wants to give you exactly what you're looking for, you know, to capture exactly what tattoo you're looking for, whether it's a sentimental piece or if it's just a fun piece, you know. The experience with you means everything to me. So thank you, everybody that's been, you know, part of New Life Inc. Without you guys, New Life Inc. would just have been an idea on a napkin, really. It wouldn't be anywhere where it's at today. I'd still be kitchen magician. Yeah, just thank you. No one to this new life we live.